What's up guys? Thank you guys so very much for joining me on my channel. This is Just the Average Guy, where I'm anything but average. And here today I'm talking about stocks. I look at the stock market every morning and I try to help beginner traders, you know, break down some easy steps to protect themselves from getting into trouble when they're trading the stock market, especially day traders. So let's look at the first stock that I traded for today, NAVB. And I got in during the break of the morning play. It, you know, gets a lot of volume in the morning, and what I'm realizing is these are not the type of trades I need to be looking for. These are not the trades that I make the most money on. Actually, I lose the most money on trying to play the open and trying to get on these green and gold trades. But I end up, you know, getting in and out on, you know, on a good price level, so it was all right. But I'm definitely gonna start staying away from these type of trades that try to go green in the morning, because as you can see here, you can easily get in trouble. Say you saw this big green bar and you decided to get on the next green bar, you're in at 85 cents. Well, it only goes up another 5 cents, and you have to quickly make a decision on when to sell. So that's exactly what I did. I got in. Let's take a look real quick. I use Robinhood to trade, so I can get the commission free. I got in at 84 cents, and I got out at 87 cents. So only 3 cents move. Not even that. It was like 84 cents and some change, and then 87 cents, 87.15. So I didn't even catch the high of it. I probably got out at this red candle at 9:34. Yep, yes sir, got out the red candle 9:34, 87 cents. So I'm definitely going to be staying away from these type of trades. This is not my good setup. This is not the type of setups I like trading now that I'm looking at the data. So let's look at the next trade I did, FRSX. These are the type of trades that I need to focus on. So if you look at FRFX, it came down here at the min line. Bam, RSI is at the dead bottom, and the stochastic oscillator is at the bottom. This is what I like. This is what I call the perfect storm. Well, this is what I was taught, the perfect storm, you know. So I'm not trying to steal, you know, someone's methodology and their terms, so making sure that I call it out as not only my own, but what a lot of traders call this. So FRX is at this bottom here, and that's what I look for to get in. I got in at the high of the 208, but if I would have been more patient, wait for the max out on RSI. It got a little max out here at the top as soon as TD Ameritrade loads up. What's going on? It's not wanting to load up too quickly. Little technical difficulties. Alright, bam, I got it. So the RSI came here to 73, and I was like, oh, you know, might as well take a little bit of profit. Got out at 218, saw this red candle come in. And, you know, green is green, you know, 208 to 218, 10 cents move, green is green. But I definitely should have held out. I'm seeing this perfect buy here, should have held out for the perfect sell. Bam, the RSI goes all the way up to 83, starts curving down. I could have got out of this red candle anywhere high. Look at this whole red candle, 218, whole 10 cents more I could have got out of that trade. But you know, it's okay. Learn, document, take a screenshot, and see what I can do better. The next trade, or the next stock I want to look at, is RVLT. RVLT went crazy here in the morning. Bam. I would stay out of this whole play because, you know, it's just a whole bunch of aggressive buying, and at any moment the stock could dump out on you. But I mean, these are nice, pretty solid green candles. Got some red here. You could just stuck with it, but it's not the type of setup I like to look for. I like to look for the dips, and here had a nice dip here. If you take a look at it, the RSI almost came below the min line. Almost came. That's still a good criteria to look for a buy. Especially after the stochastic came down almost to the midline. Look at that, 26 right there on stochastic. If you can see it, got here that 26, 24 actually on the D slow. And then I wait for the RSI to make a confirmation of going under the midline. And it almost did and hit the same numeric, you know, the same type of numbers. 26 on the RSI on below and 26 on stochastic. You know, little hints here and there. Definitely not a for sure confirmation for a buy, but definitely a good hint that you can get in on this trade. Make sure you manage your risk really good. Maybe set it for below this below the lowest candle, because you know it's hard to buy at the bottom of the candle. So you're going to be trying to based off of it of a really good price of what, like a, the price you really should have got in at. So you know, 60 cents, 58 cents would be your stop. You know, going down 2 cents, that would be a good stop, seeing that you're trying to buy a bottom. So if you would have followed the indicator, the RSI, and held out for the max, which would be a little risky seeing that it was getting into lunchtime, but seeing that you bought before lunchtime, you can held out for that max, and you can see you only got a little bit of price action, a little bit of time to sell, and you have to be quick on the trigger to get in on a good sell. But seeing that you got in at 62 cents or so, I mean, you're just playing the waiting game, and this is all a good sell area right here. So I just want to highlight some things like that. That's how I like to buy low and sell high in those type of cases. Not so much trying to buy the uptrend here and try to manage risk. More or less trying to buy low and then manage risk from there. So I hope this video was a little bit educational. I only trade low cap stocks, stocks that are under $5 or less, and just currently building up a small account. And if you want to see me on this journey and how I continue on going forward, subscribe to the channel. Definitely going to be releasing all my little knowledge that I got, my little knowledge of my 2 years experience, but I'm definitely on the come up. So see you guys in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching.